Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going to talk about 5 different ways to start micrologs. And I'm also going to recommend to you the best way to start your micrologs according to your hair type, thickness, and length. So let's get to this video. Micrologs are logs that are smaller than traditional logs. The size can range from a diameter of a drinking straw and go even smaller from there. The number of logs in micrologs can range anywhere between 300 to 1,000 depending on the size of your head, hair density, and thickness. Oftentimes, a lot of people may mistake micrologs for either traditional logs or sister logs, but they're not exactly the same. There is only a specific way in which traditional logs or sister logs can be installed. You can get more detailed information about that on one of my other videos. Because micrologs are quite versatile, there are multiple ways to maintain and start micrologs. The most common method is with interlocks, and this is where a lot of people may mistake micrologs for sister logs. Unlike sister logs, micrologs don't generally have to follow a precision parting grid. The parting can be whatever the person desires. When starting microlocks with interlocking, it's basically a locking technique whereby the end of the hair is pulled through the root to tighten the hair below all the way to the scalp. This technique can be done with a tool and with fingers. The best part about interlocking is the maintenance. The time that you have to wait between maintenance sessions is considerably longer, unlike other forms of maintenance. With interlocking, you can go anywhere between 2 to 3 months until your next maintenance session. Another upside to interlocking is that it's for all hair textures. Interlocking is a technique that can be used to start and maintain any texture of hair because it reinforces the hair to stay in place and prevents the hair from unraveling and helps to begin the locking process. This method could be quite useful for people who have relaxed, permed, or chemically treated hair. If your hair is very prone to unraveling or breakage, then you should definitely consider interlocking. Another benefit to interlocking would be for mainly aesthetic reasons. If you find the dread look a bit too overwhelming, then interlocking is definitely the option for you. Interlocking confines all your hair together and tightens the new growth and pulls the hair from the scalp. It gives you somewhat of a neat, kempt look. The downside to interlocking is that it can trigger traction alopecia if the hair is interlocked too tight, and as a result, you may end up losing some locks. Another downside to interlocking is that depending on the number of locks you have, the time necessary to complete the process may be a lot. So it's always better to consult a loctician before you start your microlocks or when you want to maintain the new growth. The interlocking technique may be challenging for some people to do it on their own because it's not exactly beginner friendly. If you want to do your own hair, you may need to take some classes or training or even practice a bit more before you can take on the task. If you are not sure about your commitment to having locks and you feel that somewhere along the way you may end up changing your mind and take down the locks, then you should not start your microlocks with interlocking. You should start your microlocks with 2-strand twists. A 2-strand twist can be achieved by splitting a section of hair into 2 and then creating a rope-like appearance by wrapping each section around the other. With a 2-strand twist, you have the option of achieving an even smaller lock size than you would achieve with any other locking method. One of the advantages to a 2-strand twist is that because it's so easy, pretty much anyone can start their locks with a 2-strand twist by doing it themselves. The best part about starting microlocks with 2-strand twists is the volume. After a while, your locks will get frizzy and as a result, enhance the volume of your hair. If you like a thicker, voluminous look, then you should definitely start your microlocks with 2-strand twists. Another advantage is that with a 2-strand twist, there are multiple ways to maintain your new growth. You can either interlock or retwist or literally 2-strand twist your new growth. I've made a video about that. I'll put the link in the description. You should consider starting your micro locks with two strand twists if you have either very long hair, low density hair, or you plan on getting more than 500 locks. I have more than 1000 locks. The downside to starting your locks with two strand twists is that if you have very soft, silky hair that is prone to unraveling, then this process would be tedious. Your locks would easily unravel and the locking process would take even longer for your hair type. Another downside to starting locks with two strand twists is the frizz. If you start your locks with two strand twists, you have to accept the upcoming transitional stages that will accompany your lock journey, and one of them is frizz, which will be followed up with shrinkage. Because locks started with two strand twists will easily unravel, it's highly recommended that you avoid frequent washes or putting water on your hair, at least within the beginning stages. I started my locks with two strand twists, and I certainly didn't follow the basic rules, and my twists, well, they unraveled. Now, did that stop my hair from locking? You tell me, do you think my hair looks any different from other micro locks? Feel free to check out my micro locks journey in the description. You also have the option of starting your micro locks with braids. Micro locks started with braids would be perfect for people with a looser hair texture or relaxed hair. This would also be a good option for people with shorter hair. One of the advantages to starting locks with braids is that your hair won't experience budding as much as other locks. And while that may be an advantage, that would also mean that your hair won't have much body or volume. Your braids will simply be flat. Another advantage that comes along with sacrificing body and volume for braid locks is that you won't experience shrinkage or frizz compared to other forms of locks. Another downside is that your locks may take longer for the braid pattern to disappear and your lock to take form. For aesthetic wise, your locks will remain more uniform and maintain a neat look. If you have low density hair, then braid locks may not be the best option for you. Another way to start your micro locks would be with coils, even though it's not that common. This method would involve using a comb to create uniform coils around your head. Because the method would involve a substantial amount of hair, the micro locks generally wouldn't be smaller than a drinking straw. The good thing about starting your locks with comb coils is that there are multiple ways to maintain your new growth. You have the option of palm rolling, you could retwist or subsequently interlock your hair. Starting your micro locks with coils would also mean that you will have to maintain your hair more frequently than other types of starter micro locks, mostly because coils are prone to unraveling more faster than braids or twists. The good thing about starting your locks with comb coils is that there are multiple ways to maintain your new growth and the time needed to complete the process. Micro locks started with coils may take longer to mature into full locks, and the journey necessary to achieve maturity may involve a lot of frizz, shrinkage, and most definitely some uncomfortable stages. One of the advantages of starting micro locks with coils is the time needed to complete the process. Comb coils would be the fastest way to get your micro locks done compared to other methods of installing your locks. Another method of starting micro locks is best suited for people with shorter hair and those not willing to wait years for their locks to grow longer. You can use hair extensions to start up with either twists or braids. As you go along the growth cycle, you can cut off the extended hair until your own hair has reached your desired length of comfort. If you're going to use hair extensions, then you should invest in human hair. Because if these extensions are going to last in your head longer than 6 months, you do not want synthetic hair rubbing on your skin for that amount of time. You should also avoid putting too much hair extensions. That would weigh your hair down too heavy and cause traction alopecia. The benefits to starting your locks with extensions could give you a glimpse of how your locks would appear at that amount of length. This would also help for women who are uncomfortable with the short and awkward stages of micro locks. If you want to start micro locks, what method among these do you think would suit your hair? Let me know at the comments section below.